Mr. Watson, would you like to lead us in prayer?
Be glad to. Bow our heads, please. Our gracious Heavenly Father, bless the day that you give us live, Lord. And Lord, be with our leaders all over the country and all the cities, that you guide us, help us, show us in the direction that you want us to go. And let's be a true instrument of our city. In God's name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You would like it?
Yes, I'll make a motion. The agenda is approved.
Okay. Dr. Sterling is approving the agenda. Anyone want to do a second on that? No? No second?
I'd like to make a motion to approve the agenda, removing item 10, planning and zoning rates.
So essentially it stays the same as we currently are in.
So it's the same as the third Monday of each month as y'all had last year. Okay. And the time is at 5:30. The only difference is that the work session, public hearings, council meetings will be here at this train depot for the council. And the downtown development will stay the same, having their meetings at 79 City Square.
great. Number four, recommendation to appoint the two new. I'm sorry.
Say the plans for me.
Sure.
For the, so for the community.
The DDA.
Yeah.
They do their own appointments.
Kumar, Dr. Kumar, Lee.
The DDA gives us recommendations from the council.
Well, they give us recommendations.
No, just the DDAs.
There's not.
Because they're not putting it, they're just putting it.
Go on.
Turn.
Yeah.
First thing, you need to.
All right, number four, well, actually, we're still in the performing board members. Number five, recommendation of council committees.
Yeah.
All right, so we did, and the council members, I have already discussed with them as well. We want to find out real quick. There it is. All right, so for public works, Mr. Ledbetter is going to take that for the committee. Public safety, Mr. Aston, will be taking over that. Cemetery, Mr. Lawson.
We have plenty of room.
Property, Mr. Carswell. Employee retention is going to be Dr. Sterling. And then for community and business will be Mr. Mims. Everybody good with that? Yes, ma'am.
Can you state my name?
Sure. You are going to be under employee retention.
Employee retention.
Questions for everybody? Are we good?
Good.
Then number six, we're going to have the recommendation for the ethic board members from Mr. Ledbetter.
Jennifer, did I enter this? Maybe.
No.
I got emailed to you, but some of the last names are going to be right. Josh and his brother.
Perfect. Josh Perfect.
Yes. What's the brother's name?
Austin.
Austin.
Same last name. And then another one I do not have was, I used to go to.
Chris Harder.
Chris Harder.
How many's on the board? Five?
Six.
Six.
And where's the board of ethics going to play exactly?
They're against a violation. They hear the violation.
Against us.
So what I got is Sam Wages. Is that right, Jennifer? Sam Wages. Brennan Chapman. I've got Kim Sell. Josh Burdett. And Austin Burdett. And Chris Harding, is that right?
Harding. So if they make decisions against us, how are they chosen? Just randomly selected?
The first three are chosen, and if the first three don't respond, you go on and on down the list until someone responds.
Okay.
So will you just go over the order again?
One, two, three is going to be Sam Wages, Brenda Chapman, Kim Sell. Three, four, five will be the Burdett, which is their brother.
Four, five, six,
I'm sorry. Chris, Josh, Austin, and Chris.
Did everybody get that? Good?
What was the last one?
Chris.
Harding.
The line number seven, Black Mountain Software for the Water Department cash receiving.
So we have started our new software. We are growing out of our software that we've had for many years. And as you probably have seen, y'all got new, the water bills look different. So that is our new software. Right now we need, if you've ever come to the city and gotten a receipt, we handwrite them. We're at the point where we can't even find the receipts that go in the book because we've been using the same system for over 20 years. So Black Mountain has a portion of the software that our customer service can go in and digitally do the receipts for water and for our general. So if you rent the depot, get a permit, we can do it where you easily get a receipt through our computer system now instead of having to handwrite like we've been doing for 20 years plus. So this is out on the table for the mayor and council to look over and approve for our new software.
Does anybody have any questions on it?
Is this one we already approved time before?
We have, you approved the overall software. This is an additional.
How much was that? What did that
up? I don't know the exact amount, but it was about $20,000. But it covers cemetery, because everything that we have now is paper. It covers water, anything to do with general, our financing, and our payroll. So it covers a lot, that $20,000.
Remember, we approved this, the portion.
That's right.
A good bit of it had already been approved before we all took off.
Mm-hmm.
It just wasn't ever being used.
So it's been approved that long?
It's been sitting there for, like, not just approved, but not in use.
Well, you're talking about Edmonds, but this has been approved since y'all have been on.
Yes,
this is Black Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, data is priceless, so I think that's important to have a new software in place for record keeping.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, the number of water bills are fixing to start getting into it.
All right, number 8 is going to be for the new health insurance coverage. Joe,
want to
go over that for the city associates?
Sure. What we've looked at is as part of trying to keep employees and hire employees, some of our benefits don't really match up with the area that we're pulling employees from. Right now, the city pays for just the employees part of the health insurance. What we're asking the council to approve is if we could offer to the employees to pay either their spouse or their children, they can pick one or the other. With family coverage, they still have some money coming out every week. But we're trying to attract, you know, some more, but we're having a hard time. We've got, the chief's got some open spaces coming up. We've got 3 open public works that we're trying to fill. We're just trying to get people to apply. What's the first question? What's your benefits? What do you offer?
Yeah.
The bigger cities, we're not a big city yet, but a lot of the bigger cities cover family coverage. So it is something we're going to try to, every 6 months or a year, come in and sit down with Federer and look for some benefits that we can offer. That this is one of the most cost prohibitive parts of the employees, besides their salaries, what we're paying for insurance. We don't know the exact cost. We wanted to come to y'all and see if y'all are good with it. We can come back with a number once we break it down and see who wants what coverage from there.
Sure.
We'd like to get y'all's approval to be able to offer that to the employees.
So, we're not going to stay with the same insurance company we have now. We're just negotiating the terms
and the coverage.
As far as
it's not negotiating the new terms.
It'll be us covering their portion of either spouse or child or their children. Child or children. It's a cost to us, but it's a benefit, I think,
yeah,
it will help attract an attraction.
We got more to offer. Stay.
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah. They want to come.
All right, number 9 for resolution 2022-4001, they're wanting to amend the personnel policy.
Yeah. The personnel policy that we amended in December, one thing that was noted to us after all the employees got to looking through it, we switched from sick leave and vacation time and rolled them into one PTO time, so you really don't have to have doctor's excuse every time you go, you know, call in, have a sick child call in sick. Well, one of the things that was pointed out to us was we were 20 hours short on each, from 3 months to a year, 1 to 4, 5 to 9, and 10 years served, we have a different rate for the number of years you serve. The easiest way to explain is if you've been here a year to 4 years, on our new policy, it's 120 hours. The employees that are hired now get 168 hours with sick time and vacation time. So what we'd like to do is bump it up to 160 hours of PTO time. It's still 8 hours shorter than what they get, but it's still PTO time, which is better than having them separate.
And a lot of companies do it that way.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're not getting hours, though. We're not accruing that many hours from, that's 160 hours from 1 to 3 years?
1 to 4 years.
1 to 4 years.
Yeah, you get 160 hours, and then 5 to 9 years is 200 hours, and over 10 is 240 hours of vacation time.
I work at the wrong place.
That's one good thing about PTO is you have a mental health day, you just want to be away. It's not really, it's not as strict as being sick or vacation.
This PTO is the same as what you offer to officers when you hire officers?
I'm not sure.
That's the last part of the policy I got to do, and I'll present that to you before February's meeting.
Okay.
That's the last chapter of the policy, and I'll be
We're the one across the board, making sure we're doing what we can to keep the best employees. We'd also like to keep the best officers.
Yes.
We will take input from citizens. Is there anyone here who wishes to address the mayor and council this evening? If so, please raise your hand. All right. I see a number of hands. I'll just call y'all up one by one. As I call you up, just a few rules of procedure. If you would approach the microphone and speak into it so everyone can hear you, please refrain from personal attacks and just address any issue you wish that relates to the city of Hoschton. I will limit each speaker to 3 minutes. As I've stated before, and I know a number of y'all have been here before, this is a time for y'all to give comments. You're welcome to ask questions. However, it's not a Q&A session, so if you ask questions, then the mayor, council, staff may choose to answer those questions later in the meeting, but we won't turn it into just a Q&A back and forth. Instead, we'll give you 3 minutes to say or ask anything you wish, as long as you keep it to City of Hoschton-related business and refrain from any personal attacks. So, ma'am, if you'd like to come up first, you just state your name, your address, whether you're a resident of the city of Hoschton, you'll have 3 minutes.
Thank you. Christina Brown, 205 Clearwater, Hoschton City resident. Just looking down through, I just had a couple comments. Number one, appreciate the transparency increase that I've seen with the new mayor. Thank you. Most of that I get through Facebook, however. There's also a Nextdoor app, and would recommend perhaps using the city's official webpage to post maybe more information, some more current stuff, I don't know, from the agenda each month to the minutes following the agenda to, I think we could make better use of the official city webpage for those people who choose not to participate in social media, and that's just a suggestion. I also like the change of venue for the meetings. There's no room here. I'm not standing today. To item number one, the city council meetings. I don't know if it's up for discussion. It could be discussed to maybe push it back to 6 o'clock instead of 5:30. Some of us really struggle to get here by 5:30 and literally have to leave work early. I think that we want more citizen input, more citizen participation. And I think that if we just push it 30 minutes, you might be able to see, especially since the public comment portion of the meeting is the first thing. That's just a thought I had there. And then I didn't really expect to have a comment, but item number 8, health insurance coverage. I work for a big healthcare system, and I don't know what your insurance is going to look like, but if it gets cost prohibitive to offer to cover spouse or dependents, you can always maybe cover half of the cost of the spouse or half of the cost of the dependents once you get into that area. My system doesn't cover spouse or dependents fully at no cost to me, that's for sure. I even contribute portion of mine. Not that you're, I'm comparing apples to apples, because I know government work, city work, it's a whole different thing. But instead of just paying it all or paying none, you might be able to come up with some sort of compromise with paying a portion, offering a portion, still be enticing. So that's really it. Thank you.
All right, anyone else on this side? Come on up, you state your name, your address, and whether you're a resident of the city of Hoschton. You'll have 3 minutes.
Harry McGowan, 205 Quail Run. Yes, I'm a resident of the city. I like this format where you guys are facing us, giving us, you know, if we can't hear you, maybe we can read the lips a little bit. Maybe add some microphones to your tables, because it is harder to hear on the back or hard on the back. I think this is more appropriate because the other way felt kind of distant, especially when some developers come through and start talking. It just seems it's a better system. I want to congratulate the mayor for making it to the table here. I just want to hear input on some of the other stuff, so that's all I have.
Thank you. All right, anyone else on this side? All right, Mr. Butler, or ma'am, I saw your hand. If you'd come up, if you would state your name, your address, whether you're a resident of the city of Hoschton, you'll have 3 minutes.
My name is Sue Youngblood from Jefferson Street here in Hoschton. My question is item 10, why it was not even discussed. It seems like a very important issue to the community, and I would like each council member to tell me each individually why they voted to not even discuss it. Let's start with Mr. Lawson.
As I stated in my preliminary, this is not a Q&A session. You're welcome to ask any questions that you like. And then if they choose to answer them later in the meeting, they will. But otherwise, you'll have 3 minutes to state or ask anything you like. And then you can step down. We'll go through the rest of the comments. And if they wish to respond, they can.
Okay, that is my question. This is a very important issue to the community. And to not even discuss it seems very invalid for a council member, especially in public, and I would like to hear their reasons why they won't even discuss it. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Mr. Butler, I think I saw your hand raised. You come up, say your name, your address, with your resident of the city of Hoschton. You'll have 3 minutes.
So I'm Scott Butler, resident of the city of Hoschton. And I'm going to ask respectfully up front that I get 5 minutes, because I timed this and it takes 5 minutes.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Mr. Butler. We do limit to 3 minutes, so best we can.
Mr. Mayor O'Leary, concerned citizens and new council members, I want to relay the actual chain of events that led to the original elimination of the Planning and Zoning Commission, because many have heard a false narrative that elimination of the commission had to do with financial concerns. In February of 2021, the former mayor called me to meet him at City Hall and due to past experiences, I asked Mr. John Carton to accompany me as an observer. When we arrived, the former mayor was joined by Adam Ledbetter and Tracy Carswell. After listening to the former mayor rant for a few minutes about the Planning and Zoning Commission not doing what they were told to do, I explained to the mayor that the Planning and Zoning Commission, according to the Red Book of the GMA, the Georgia Municipal Association, was for the Planning Commission to be free of political influence and review all applications against the city's comprehensive plan and zoning ordinances on the books of the city. The former mayor expressed to us that, in not very calm words, that he did not really give a damn about that and that the commission needed to do what we were told. Within a few weeks of that meeting, on March the 9th, the planning and zoning members, the city council members, and city clerk sent an email eliminating the Planning and Zoning Commission. There had been no public discussion, certainly no public vote amongst council members and the mayor. There had only been an executive session in February where, according to a sitting council member, there was discussion led by the mayor and Mr. Aston to remove me personally from the Planning and Zoning Commission. And according to Mr. Carville and Lawson, also were in favor of that. According to this sitting city council member, Mr. Hayes suggested that removing only me would be difficult to do legally and would have had bad optics. Mr. Hayes' recommendation was to eliminate the entire Planning and Zoning Commission. I am assuming the former mayor learned that he cannot individually eliminate the planning and zoning, or that the email sent on March the 9th indicated an illegal meeting of the council where a vote was taken and not publicly displayed. The meeting room was full the last evening of our last Planning and Zoning Commission meeting, with many citizens speaking against the elimination of the commission. No citizen spoke in favor of eliminating the commission. The commission members then voted unanimously to retain the Planning and Zoning Commission. So any voices that say there was no participation by citizens to retain the commission are ignorant or misstating the facts. During the hearing, the false narrative about cost was floated. I asked Mr. Weitz, our planning commission person, if he was taking a reduction of fees. His answer was no. I asked the city clerk if her paycheck was going to be smaller. Her response was no. At the next city council meeting, they voted to eliminate the commission, ignoring the room full of citizens that had shown up and attended the previous planning and zoning meeting, and the commission's recommended vote to not eliminate the planning and zoning commission. I would have respected the former mayor and those four council members if they would have just said in a public meeting, we don't like Scott Butler standing up for the citizens of Hoschton by requiring that new zoning requests adhere to our comprehensive plan.
Mr. Butler, you can wrap it up. I'm sorry, your time is complete.
Thank you. We deserve we desire that developers make hundreds of millions of dollars from our community and leave our citizens holding financial and lifestyle liabilities. Yeah.
Thank you.
At least then I could have respected.
Thank you, Mr.
Yeah.
I've got copies of all of this.
All right. Do we have any other persons on this side of the room who'd like to speak?
Somebody can finish reading that for you.
Mr. Carden, if you would state your name, your address with your resident city of Hoschton, you'll have 3 minutes.
I am John Carden. I am a resident of the city of Hoschton. I am paraphrasing and borrowing from Dr. Martin Luther King here. We need leaders not in love with money or themselves. We need leaders in love with doing right and loving their fellow citizens in Hoschton. Our elected officials for the last 5 or 6 years have been committed to allowing landowners, developers, and investors to make hundreds of millions of dollars in Hoschton and leave. Then the citizens get unbearable traffic, increased school bond, and school maintenance and operation taxes, the risk of water rationing within 15 to 20 years, inevitably an increased millage rate, property taxes from the city of Hoschton to pay for elaborate schemes from the DDA, and a bloated operational budget in the city. Had this really been about saving money, then the following would not be in the 2022 budget. $38,000 for the mayor and council to go on vacation to Jekyll Island, stop paying yourselves $500 a month for 2 hours of meeting time, a savings of $46,000 a year, withdraw the $50,000 allocated for the DDA this year. These saving measures alone can net the city $134,000 easily. This is an email from the former mayor Sell sent to the Planning and Zoning Commission on March 9, 2021. Planning and Zoning Commission members, good morning, everyone. I wanted to be the one to personally share this update with each one of you. If you have preferred to notify you either in person or by phone, but felt it more important that it reach everyone at the same time. Your time and efforts for our Planning and Zoning Commission have been much appreciated by the council and myself. However, after much discussion, I would like to see the minutes of all the meetings where this issue was discussed. We believe we can streamline the process and save the city money. When I asked both the city planner and city clerk, they said that their pay would not change. By eliminating the Planning and Zoning Commission, Jerry Weitz, Navid Hayes will be working together to make a smooth transition over the next month. Do not want to cause any unnecessary delays. What this means is there will be no delays for citizens, there will only be delays for developers and landowners, taking hundreds of millions of dollars out of Hoschton. Jerry has informed me that there are actually some of the ordinances the commission will hear in the March meeting. Also, as many of you are aware, we are forming a downtown development authority and request that each of you consider serving on that group. Your knowledge would be valuable to the authority. Jennifer has applications at City Hall, and we hope to have the DDA formed within the next 60 days. Please stop by at your convenience and fill out one. Again, I will say that your service has been much appreciated. Please feel free to contact me or your council members directly. you have any questions, we prefer phone calls or in-person meetings, or you can meet me at a gun store if possible. Yes, heaven forbid there's a paper trail. Yours truly, Shannon Sale, Mayor. So this is really about saving the city of Hoschton money. Stop spending $38,000 for the mayor and council to go on vacation. Stop paying yourself $500 a month and withdraw the $50 allocated for the DDA this year. Thank you.
All right, any other persons who wish to offer citizen input? All right, then I'll turn it back over to you, Mr. Mayor. Ms. Mayor, Madam Mayor.
All right, so with that, we can just adjourn, all done.
Okay.
Motion to adjourn, anyone?
Make a motion to adjourn. Second.
All in favor? All opposed?
Just a note, the work session has ended. They have adjourned the meeting. The regular session will not begin at 5:30 as always.
All right, so now at 6:01, we will call to order the council meeting. Agenda approval.
One through nine, we all agree on putting on the consent agenda.
So you're making a motion to approve
I'll
the agenda
with
one through nine to be on the consent agenda?
Yes, sir.
All nine on the consent?
All nine on the consent agenda.
The agenda with items one through nine under new business to be part of a consent agenda.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Ledbetter, you made a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Let me interject. Okay. Mr. Aston, if you're opposing because there's an item that was placed on the consent agenda that you don't agree with, then I think the appropriate way to handle that would be that Mr. Aston make a motion to remove whatever item or items he doesn't wish to be on the consent agenda from it, so that it's clear when we take a vote what you're voting for and what you're voting against, if that makes sense. You follow me there?
Well, most of it's just like just the principles and comments. Like, of course, one and two, I think those need to be separate votes because we're accepting a resignation, and then you're appointing two new members. Of course, I just think those need to be separate votes. That's just me personally. So just one and two is your like three and four ten. That's it. The rest of it will be responded. It's only three and four.
Okay. Councilman Aston, why don't you make a motion to remove from the consent agenda items three and four, and we'll just take those up separately. That way it's clear who's voting for what.
Then I make the motion to remove items three and four from the consent agenda. Second.
All in favor? All opposed? All right, so then we'll just jump straight to the consent to get all the
minute
approval?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so minute approval for the meetings on December 20th, and then bear with me, 22nd and 3rd, but the new members can only approve the minutes for the 3rd. Because the first two we were not here at the table.
So then you want to do separate motions for, So I make a motion to approve the minutes for December 20th, 2021 public hearing work session, work council session, and the minutes for December 22nd, 2021 special call meetings.
Second. All in favor? Nope. Dr. Sterling, you can't do this. Yeah, you're done. So everybody
since
else
you,
all in favor.
Since you were here, Dr. Sterling. Yes.
All right, so with our prior city council members, all in favor. That one was a tricky one. Then January 3rd.
I make a motion to approve January 3rd, 2022 special call meeting minutes.
Second.
All in favor? All opposed? Nope. All right. So for new business, do we want to jump to the consent first?
Yeah, I think a motion would be in order to approve the consent agenda, which as I understand it consists of items 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9.
I make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
I'll second that. All in favor? All opposed? All right, so with that, we'll go back to, you said 3 and 4, so line 3, which was accepting the two resignations for the DDA.
I make a motion to accept the resignations. Anita Bowie and Ray Vaughn from the DDA.
Second.
All in favor? All opposed? All right, and then number 4, the recommendation to appoint the two new board members for the DDA.
I make a motion to appoint Marshall Hunter and Jeff Parkinson, yes, Parkinson to the DDA, with Marshall Hunter's term being January 20th, 2022 to May 9th, 2025. It's finishing the term of Mr. Ray Vaughn, Jeff Parkinson, January 20th, 2022 to May 9th, 2023, finishing the term for Ms. Anita Bowie.
Second.
All in favor?
Are they here by chance?
Yes.
I'm Jeff Parkinson.
Hi,
well, hey, thank you.
Thank you for your volunteering.
Thank you for
excited.
Looking forward to it.
Right. So you did a second?
Yep.
All in favor? All opposed?
And Marsha Hunter, is she here?
Dr. Hunter, she couldn't join here. She has some prayer appointment, so she apologized. She will meet with you guys later.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. So executive session, which we will need for litigation, real estate, and then also personnel.
All three. I make a motion to go to executive session for litigation, real estate, and personnel.
Second motion.
All in favor? All opposed?
Let's walk back.
Mr. Hill?
Yes, ma'am.
My name's Katie Corcoran.
Hey.
And I know you don't have time right now, but I'm going to need to file a police report.
Okay.
I don't know if you have time tonight or if you'd rather me come back tomorrow.
Okay.
What's going on? Tomorrow, about what time would be good for you?
I'm here from 7 to 4 tomorrow.
7 to 4?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And you'll be at City Hall, is
yes,
that
ma'am.
Correct? All right, thank
and
you.
And if I'm not there, they can call me on my cell phone.
All right. Thank you. Yeah.